Great. Hello, good evening, everyone. Om Namah Shivaya, friends. I am Shweta Rai, founder of The Eternal Yoga and national head of Global Womenpreneur League. Today, I take the privilege and honor to invite our guest, Shweta Singh, on the live conversation today. About Shweta Singh, I would like to mention that she is a dynamic and a beautiful individual, woman, who has had a diverse and successful career. She has done immense projects. She has had many achievements. She is the first female pilot, gold medalist from state of Uttar Pradesh, and a lot more. So let me take the privilege and honor to invite Shweta. Shweta Singh, can we have you? Hi, good evening, Shweta.
Namaskar and very good evening. Hi, Shweta. Thank you so much for such a warm welcome and kind words. It is an honor to receive it from someone who is herself an inspiring woman entrepreneur in her field. So, Shweta, once again, thank you. I would also like to extend my gratitude to our esteemed audience. I'm so privileged to be here today on this wonderful platform organized by GWC, Aspire to Inspire. I'm here humbled, enriched, and committed as I look around to each one of you who has selflessly dedicated their voice, their time, and their heart into helping the world see light. You are all so inspiring and your perspective gives me hope.
Very true, very true. And indeed, it is an honor for us, you know, that you are here and you're going to share about your journey, about your achievements. And I was going through the, the journey of yours, and I found it so very, you know, motivating and inspiring that it's definitely an honor that you are there and, you know, we'll be sharing the entire journey of yours today. So, Shweta, before we go ahead, I would like to give a small introduction of yours, if you can just let us know.
Just to introduce about myself, if I start talking about my journey, how I started. So I would just like to, you know, put some lights on that. So Shweta, my life and my experience were certainly not a bed of roses by any means. However, my attitude from the get-go was always to be content with the resources available to me. This helped me to become tenacious and ambitious towards achieving my goals, both in the short and long term. So from the time that I can remember, growing up in a rural part of Uttar Pradesh and my home's unique presented challenges to have an education. In order to reach my school each morning involved being awoken at 4:30 a.m., a cycle ride to a river which circumvented our village, a makeshift boat crossing followed by public transport all the way to school. In total, it would take me nearly 2.5 hours to reach school every time. And inclement weather during the monsoon made the river crossing all the more interesting. More challenges were, you know, not having proper electricity, which would sometimes carry on even for more than 2 to 3 days due to bad weather, rain, and many other unavoidable circumstances. I still recall studying under the lantern or wherever I could find some light to finish my homework. But the biggest challenge for me was to be born as a girl, which resulted in prejudicial social attitudes towards education, independence, and to have an ambition. Often my loose talk of my dreams was met with skepticism and ridicule from the local society by comments to my parents such as, Beti to paraya dhan hai, why wasting so much of money on education? It had stopped saving for her marriage. Never want to be put down by anyone. The biggest shock in my life came, you know, when I suddenly lost my father, who was my hero at a very young age. And overnight, our lives were turned upside down. This resulted in enormous pressure on my mother, my younger sister, and I. With no father in a strongly male-dominated community. In particular, I was used by the community to get me married at a very young age. If I, as a female, was about to get, you know, written off. But I refused to be the victim of circumstances into which I was born. I stood against all odds with the support, trust and confidence of my idol, my mother. I took charge of my own future, irrespective of my gender, that I can be the soldier for children. I'm no girl, no dead instinct with me. I'm free to be with an independent will. So, you know, this is how my story starts, Shweta. More about, you know, I don't want to talk about at present what I'm doing. And, you know, there are a lot of things are going in my plate, in my, you know.
Yes, yes. Shweta, you're not audible, dear.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, now it's better. Because like as you have just mentioned that it was really difficult for you to, you know, go to school and things were not, you know, on your side at that time. But still, because of your mom, she was the support behind you and she really encouraged you. And she was the one who motivated you and she said that, no, my children will go to school, you know, and they'll not get married and all that. But really that guts that you had, that you, you know, overcome all that things and you went to school and the achievements that I was just going through that, you know, you were the first female pilot gold medalist. So over the period of time, you know, you have achieved so much with your willpower, Shweta. So how does it feel now when you think about all those things?
When I think about those things, Shweta, I feel, you know, it's still, there is a lot of things to be done, you know. For me, I want to do everything, anything possible, whatever, you know, it comes in my way. I want to try everything. I want to be someone, you know. I don't want any Shweta to suffer the way I did during my time. That if someone, you know, if you lose someone in the family and get the kind of tag that you are a girl, you are not, you won't be able to do this. I want that, you know, that mentality to be out from his mind. Because what important is, you know, no matter whether you're a girl or whether you're a boy, you know, you are all the same. Everybody has got a choice. Everybody has a right to voice. Everybody has got a and Shweta also to say one thing that I was very lucky because, you know, I had three very strong women in my life. And one is my lifeline, my mother, my aunt, and my mother. So from the very beginning, they have taught me the, you know, very important thing to have confidence. And they said that circumstances and but the most important thing is to have big dreams. Circumstances doesn't matter in your life. What matters
very
is
true.
Life.
Very true.
I think that there's still a lot of things to be done. Life is very important, and, you know, and I want to be, you know, something like I want to leave a legacy when I'm gone. So this is what I'm trying to
do. I completely agree with you because we have always seen ki you know, situations, paristhiti jaisi bhi ho, but if you have the zeal, if you are confident and you have that backup, you have that support. Agar main kehti hu ki us time pe agar kisi ek insaan ka bhi support aapko mil jaye, so it is very easy, you know, for you to go overcome all those things. And today we see you as a strong personality and you are into so many things. I could also see that you you had won a state level boxing championship. Can you please share something about that?
This is quite amazing, Shweta. During my college times, we used to have a lot of athletic work. Being on, we used to participate in badminton, cricket, everything. Because after my studies, I used to take out my time, apart from my flying exercise, which was going on. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to do something else as well on the side. So I did mountaineering. You know, I wanted to get, I love adventures. I don't know why. I love skydiving. I love, you know, going under the water.
Full of adventures, right?
I think in this life, you need to try everything.
Very true.
And this is not because I wanted to prove myself that I'm not less than a boy or not less than a guy. That was not my intention. I love enjoying my life. So this is how I got into boxing and it was fun because, you know, it's the training teaches you to be very tough. I remember people used to tell me, don't do this. If you, you know, something gets knocked, if you lose your nose or eyes or something, what will happen? How will you get married? Because that's the main,
yeah, that's
main issue always happens. And then I said, it's fine for me, no matter if they break my nose, but at least, you know, I tried in my life. I would, you know, one tick in my bucket list if this has been done. So, yeah.
So that's what, because being a girl, you know, we always, like parents are always worried ki, you know, take care of yourself, shaadi kaise hogi, aap ladki ho, aapko dhyan dena hoga. So a lot of things are there in the society. But again, if you have that willpower and like you said ki, you wanted to do everything and you have done it very successfully, I should mention that. And also, you know, how did you feel when you were crowned Mrs. India? So that would have been an amazing, you know, because you look so beautiful.
Oh, that's really kind of you, Shweta. Mrs. India Worldwide was a very, you know, amazing adventure of my life. It was after my marriage. And then I moved back to India with my husband. My husband is a British citizen and in India as well. So it was just an opportunity. It happened, you know, once I got a call from one of the, you know, one person saying that, you'd like to join Mrs. India Worldwide? We have got this audition going on. And this is nice.
Shweta, this again, you're not audible.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, better. I think there's some network issues. Well, anyways, that will not stop us from going, right? So moving on, Shweta, you know, it was a moment of pride for all of us, including you, obviously, because you were awarded by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. And I saw the video that you just, you know, came out of the helicopter and you gave a bouquet to Manmohan Singh. So all these things, you know, though it seems very, you know, easy, but I don't think it is so easy. And you know, how did you do all those things, and what really motivated you, you know, to be the first pilot?
Well, Shweta, this, if I talk about, this is in the year 2004.
Mm-hmm. You can just come a bit closer to the mic, Shweta. I hope that would be, yeah. Just
so initially, you know, I found the training very grueling and often felt like giving up. However, I was resolute in my belief not to be defeated, which resulted in my achievement. To be a pilot is to live among the clouds. The training and discipline required were very intense. However, it was all worth it. Once you are lifted up in the sky, you know, the feelings are always a combination of exhilaration, excitement, and freedom. And I would never tire of the amazing views and never forgot the privilege to such an experience. And also, Shweta, when I look back at this part of my life, it was all filled with excitement and upliftment. Positive thinking, and more importantly, practical steps forward allowed me to progress. Dealing with matters at hand and not overthinking allowed me to succeed here. I can confidently say one success spurned another by providing me with the confidence to continue and to not fear defeat, especially in such a competitive environment as this was. And, you know, this is what inspired me, the confidence. And I feel like whatever I achieved with these young leaders in, you know, in my life, who you know, I had the opportunity to be felicitated by them, like Honorable President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Honorable Prime Minister of India, Dr. Manmohan Singh. It was something which is like always in my mind, in my memory. And I remember each and everything happening that day. You know, still now I can recall each and every moment happened. And I still recall when I spoke to my mother after the air show, after I gave bouquet to the Prime Minister. I can just only hear her screaming on the phone. That's only, you know, and I, that was the amazing feeling. I was like, at least now I'm able to bring a smile on my mother's face. So this was something it's remarkably, you know, in my memories for lifetime.
Indeed, because, you know, you have experienced that. And now that you are just sharing this, I'm getting goosebumps all over. And because, you know, being a mother, I can understand how much pain she must have gone through, like alone she was there, and, you know, she took care of both of your sisters. I think you have two sisters, right? Yeah. So definitely it would have been a great time, and she would have seen you doing this. And बोलते हैं ना कि उस समय वो खुशी का इजहार करना और उस खुशी को बयान करना, उसको शेयर कर पाना शायद एक माँ के लिए संभव नहीं है. That is like beyond words.
Yeah, sure. But that's true. You know, I still remember when they announced the results. I was there for the first, the female pilot who was going to win the gold medal. I was very neutral. I don't know why. You know, my colleagues, they came in to congratulate me. A lot of other, you know, my friends, they were like, if I would have been at your place, I'd have jumped from the terrace, you know, out of happiness. And I'm like, no, this is just the beginning, you know. It's no stopping now. It's a lot of things needs to be done. And this is just what I have started, thanks to my mother for believing in me and having the confidence. And yeah, so this is how I started.
Certainly, obviously, you know, a lot of us will should learn from your life that because nowadays we have seen, and I also being into you know, this healing modality, I see people, you know, coming under depression, under anxiety because of very small and petty issues. But you know, you have so much in life to do, because hum jaise kehte hain ki agar life mein ek darwaza hamare liye band ho jata hai to definitely hamare liye aur 10 darwaze khul jate hain. But you know, you should look for that opportunity, which is very important. And as you said, that that positivity should always be there, no matter what the circumstances be. So, बहुत जरूरी है आज के लिए एक message convey करना through you, Shweta, that परिस्थिति कुछ भी हो, situations कैसे भी हो, but अगर आप में वो zeal है, अगर आप में वो कुछ कर गुजरने की वो चाहत है, तो definitely nobody can stop you. What do you say?
That's true, Shweta. I completely agree what you said at the moment, because you know, when I talk about my life experience, like we are talking about my success story.
Mm-hmm. Shweta, just come a bit closer to the mic. With voice getting, yeah.
The success story just not just started, like, you know, it happened and then I continued. There was no stopping me. Lot of downfall. You know, a lot of time I have fallen, and then every time I just got up and dusted myself off. You know, well, I mean, I talk about when I was buoyed by my success, the challenges were only just the beginning, you know, because there was no budget available for me to continue into master's program after my graduation. And my younger siblings were still in the midst of their education, and incomes for farmers were decreasing year on year. So following my graduation after my college, I then gave up studying in order to meet the responsibilities for my family. So, you know, it's just, we feel that, why is it happening to me, you know? It happened like you are on the top and then all of a sudden you're falling down. But then, you know, I embraced everything in my life. I still remember the first job I started, my first income was 8,000 rupees. And I was so happy because I was like, now I'm doing something. This is what I need for my family, you know? My mom doesn't have to take any loan for my education or for my sister's education. And we don't have to sell any property. We can work out everything. So, you know, this was the first thing, and that 8,000 rupees, I still remember, I was so satisfied with that, you know, no matter how much I earn today, but I understand the value of money, how important it was during that time, and, you know, how much I sacrificed. I won't say sacrifice, because it was just, you know, something happened and I came out of it. So people, they get, you know, they're worried about, like, the situation happening right now with COVID-19. You know, the one thing is, never lose hope. That's the very
life. I completely agree. That is what the whole idea here is, that one must never lose hope, because if you lose hope, then there's, you know, no going ahead in life. And obviously it looks very easy at times ki, you know, you got Miss India crown or Miss World crown and you were the first pilot who got gold medalist. But you know, a lot of things are there, as you have just mentioned ki, back of the mind struggle always thi aapke saath, you know, to take care of your family, and as you were growing up you had a lot of challenges, but still, you know, I think this was your positivity that kept you moving all the time. Or ek jo bolte na ki karna hai kuch, and never to lose hope, never to give up, that confidence was there in you, Shweta, which I think, you know, made you prove what you are.
So, you know what, Shweta, the thing is, opportunities, we know, they're not fairly distributed to people, right?
Very.
But it's just, you know, how can you break those boundaries and, you know, grab those opportunity and make the best use out of it? This is what it is. You know, of this time. So just grab the opportunities, you know, just, you know, innovate your stuff. God has given you so many things, you know, a brain to think about, you know, some people are very good in doing, like artistic stuff. Some people are very good in cooking stuff. Some are good in baking. You know, like, we have got so many talents. The only thing is to realize them, you know, how best we can, you know, innovate our mind and everything, and, you know, display the, you know, the best of you at the same time.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with you on this point that we should never lose hope. We should always keep ourselves going, no matter what the conditions are, because obviously this is a life. And this will always be, you know, a roller coaster a journey for all of us. You know, you cannot expect everything happening good and everything, you know, happening bad as well. So you have to be prepared for each and everything. And Shweta, as we have gone through your profile and, you know, your... So we were just also having a look that you have done a lot of social work, especially in the villages. Can you please throw some light on that?
Okay, so this journey of my philanthropy work started in the year 2018. So after following my marriage to a British citizen, then after I participated in Miss India Worldwide 2018, during the same time, I was invited to be as a brand ambassador for IIT Delhi Alumni Association, which was the Swachhata initiative.
Okay.
So, and my desire to give back the rural heartland where I belong, to be the voice of peers, my community, and be the advocate of young girls and women who may not have the opportunity like me. So as a brand ambassador, I was an integral part of a diverse team, which went through to adopt 150 villages across various states.
Yes.
In educational facilities and wastewater management for the chosen villages. And given my own experiences of growing up in a village and how I had to struggle to have a better life for me and my family, as well as realizing the talent and drive that exists in our rural populace, led me to found NABHAMI, which is the National Ambassador for Villages and Aspiration Commission. Apart from NABHAMI, we have so many other things we are doing at the moment. A lot of things are going to come ahead, you know, in future, which we are working on those things as well. So I'm working with LGBTQ community. This is all, you know, it's happening because of the encouragement of my family. They are always there to support me, my husband, my in-laws, you know, everybody is like so supportive in this, because whenever I ask or try something, they are like, they motivate me, they encourage me. Yes, you can, you know, just go ahead for this. No matter what happens, the result is maybe people won't be happy. They might not like the way you are trying to do stuff, you know, things people, but you don't care about that. What thing is inside your heart? If you believe in yourself that you can give the best out of to the people and achieve what you're looking for, then just go ahead with that. So this was always there.
Yes, it's very true. Because obviously, you know, if beforehand only if we think what the consequences will be, you know, we will not be able to start any work. So, and definitely the support of our family is very important, especially being a lady, right? Because agar hum koi bhi kaam karne ke liye nikalte hain, to agar hume hamare family ka support nahi hota hai, hamare in-laws ka, if you are married and if you don't get the support of your in-laws or your husband, then things become a little difficult for, you know, any one of us. And very true that, you know, whatever you have done, you have always you were successful because you knew you had that passion and you had that positivity in you. Right? Shweta, when we talk about, you know, coming from a rural place and totally a change makeover, or we can say that, you know, many things change. So, how did you feel? Like, suppose if you want to convey any message, agar hum kisi ko koi message aaj bhi hamare villages mein, hamare gaon mein, sab jagah bahut sari ladies, khair ab to awareness bahut zyada badh gayi hai. People are, you know, giving equal treatment to their daughters, and there is no, I don't think ki apko aisa discrimination hai ki beta hai beti hai. I don't think so. Obviously there is there and that always will be there, but things have changed over a period of time. So what do you message you would want to convey to them ki ab agar koi bhi ek lady ya koi bhi ek ladki ek village se aa rahi hai to wo challenges kya kya hote hain, matlab what challenges you faced, you know, when you came out from that village, and then how did you...
If I talk about challenges, after my first job, it was with the Defence Academy, and I used to train young aspirational leaders and defence personnel. After that, you know, it was just an opportunity happened. Like, I was checking something online, and then I saw this walk-in interview for JET. And then I went for the interview, and I still remember, I didn't know anything about how to do a makeup. Because these things, you don't learn anyways, right?
Right.
It was invented in the year 2005. So I didn't even know the chance, you know, how to go on YouTube and check, you know, how the makeup stuff is being done. So the only thing I did was put a lipstick and I went for the interview.
Okay.
And there were a lot of rounds. We have extempore, you know, introduction and final interviews, your grooming session. So during the grooming session, this, you know, this colleague, she came and she said, you need to do something about your, you know, some makeup, at least some eyeliner. Some kajal for the final. And I said, I don't know how to do it. So it's like, you know, it's, I'm just giving an example about like things, you know, you don't have to make excuses. Success doesn't need people who are good in making excuses. It's just that, you know, I learned. No matter if the YouTube wasn't there, just remember, Shweta, during our time, I understand Google was invented in 1998, right?
Yes.
But when we used to get homework from our teachers, we used to just ask our parents, and if they don't go to the library, maybe ask our teachers, you know? So resources were not that available, but still we used to try, you know, any matter, whatever it could be, to finish our work some way or the other. So it's just that we might say that, you know, गाँव में बिजली नहीं होती, सड़क अच्छी नहीं है, ये प्रॉब्लम है, यहाँ पढ़ाई नहीं हो सकती, बट आई स्टडी फ्रॉम देयर, आई केम फ्रॉम अ रूरल पार्ट ऑफ अ विलेज, नो मैटर हाउ फार माय स्कूल वाज, आई यूज्ड टू ट्रैवल, यू नो, लाइक इट वाज लाइक 25 किलोमीटर्स ऑफ माय जर्नी एंड देन कमिंग बैक कंप्लीटली, यू नो, 50 किलोमीटर्स ऑफ जर्नी, एंड स्टिल आई यूज्ड टू मैनेज डूइंग माय होमवर्क इन द ट्रांसपोर्ट जस्ट टू मेक श्योर दैट आई डोंट मिस आउट ऑन एनीथिंग. सो चैलेंजेस इज लाइक, यू नो, दिस इज काइंड ऑफ समथिंग लाइक इन लाइफ. There will be a lot of hurdles. You'll be falling off or falling every time. But then the most important thing is, you know, just take the best, the moment, whatever it's in front of you, just don't give up. Don't make excuses. Just go for it. And if, you know, if you have an encouraging family like I have, and I'm so proud of them, you know, I think then nothing is impossible for you. Every girl, no matter whether you come from a village, from a very remote area where, you know, you don't have any resources, but then, you know, now we have so many things. We can travel, we can do internet.
Yes.
Oh, now online, you're doing this webinar, you know,
get everything very easily now. It's very easy.
So if this can be done, then I think, like, you know, now we have resources, and what was possible during my time when we didn't have, you know, mobile phone and everything, still I managed to do so many other things, and other people were still doing them, you know, landlines and everything. So if now the resources are available for you, just make the best use of it and just go ahead for that. Now the world has become a very small place. It's not, you know, no more like so many 100 kilometers you have to travel to go from one place to another. Like every day we are connected, you know, because I told you my husband is from United Kingdom, just on a Zoom call or, you know, anything, just you connect with each other and you just see your family every day. So it's possible now, you know. So for every young female, no matter wherever you are, any part of the world, just don't give a hope, you know. Have the ability to achieve any dream you have in your mind and just dream big. Dream so big that, you know, you just go ahead and do whatever you like and just go for it.
Completely agree with you, because, you know, कोई काम अगर हम कर रहे हैं और हम अपनी पूरी हिम्मत के साथ, पूरी मेहनत के साथ अगर हम उसको करते हैं, so any lame excuse or if you don't want to do that, then things are totally different. But aaj ki date mein, jaisa you have just also mentioned ki aaj ki date mein hamare paas sab kuch bahut easily available hai, be it technology, be it knowledge, be it anything for that matter. Also in villages nowadays we have good transportation, roadways, everything is there. So it depends on a person, right, ki aap mein kitni capability hai aur aap us capability se kaise usko convert karte ho apne success mein.
That's true, Shweta. Even I would like to add, you know, like one of the traits I have lived my life is to always, you know, to complete the journey that you set out to conquer, right? So no matter how long it may take, as I mentioned earlier, although it was my wish, I was unable to pursue further education after completing my initial graduation from university, as due to financial constraints and the responsibilities I had to discharge towards my family. But however, I had never lost sight of this goal, and I'm truly thrilled that to have been accepted into Oxford University in the United Kingdom, which is one of the, you know,
right,
amazing things in my life.
It was simply
that me from the village achieve her dream and have the strength to pave her own path, then anyone with courage and resilience can take ownership of their destiny.
So I think it's an amazing, you know, thing that you have just shared, that, you know, getting admission in Oxford University is like a dream come true, right?
I'm taking all the credit, but it's all because of my husband and my family.
That's always there. And it is really nice of you that you give them the, you know, the side that, you know, they really helped you out. And that's really commendable, because obviously as you have said and even I added to it that jab tak aapko family ka support nahi hai, parivar ka support nahi hai, things become a little difficult for any one of us. So it was like I'm talking to you and I, you know, I can imagine all the things that must have gone through, you know, you must have, you know, observed and gone through all those things. Like, bahut, you know, I really feel so happy for you and I really feel so proud being a lady, you know. You're an inspiration, Shweta. Seriously.
You know, when I had, you know, when we had this question answer round during Mrs. India Worldwide, the, you know, there was the last thing what I said to them was, I always want to pray God that agle janam mohi biti hai ki, because I'm so proud what I am and any life I want to be the same, you know, I want to be born as a female. That's it.
Very true, very true. Because obviously, when we are born, it doesn't matter you are a girl or a boy. आप किस जगह से आते हो, आपकी फैमिली में कौन है, आपकी परवरिश कैसे हुई, यू नो, ऑब्वियसली ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर देयर, बट अगेन इट इज यू हु मेक्स इट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे, यू नो, इट टोटली डिपेंड्स ऑन यू कि आप कैसे उन सिचुएशंस से फाइट करते हो, कैसे आप अपने आप में वो कैपेबिलिटी लाते हो, वो एनर्जी लाते हो कि आप हर चैलेंज को ओवरकम कर सकते हो एंड यू कैन शो द वर्ल्ड दैट डेफिनेटली बी एट एनी विलेज, बी एट, यू नो, बिकॉज वी हैव सीन पीपल having good monetary conditions, but still, you know, they are struggling. So it is not only money, it is, but it is your willpower and your dedication that, you know, helps you all the way.
That's true.
And currently, what are your projects, Shweta, if you can just share that also with us.
Bobby?
Yeah, if you can just share the current projects that you're working on.
Yeah, so can you hear me, Shweta?
Yeah, now you're audible, please.
So yeah, so my first project is Namami, which exists as an organization, which is and companies and cooperators who are interested to invest in such locations. So you know, as India is a country where over 2/3 of the population continues to live in rural areas, and as such represents a concentration of India's strength. Secondly, with the federal government encouraging complex Make in India schemes, which are struggling to get off the ground, a major market lies in investment in cottage industries within the rural sector. So having spoken, you know, and worked extensively with a number of multinational firms and domestic co-ops, we are struggling to find the mechanism to reach the
yes.
And my experiences on both sides of the coin, I felt my organization can act as a necessary bridge for both parties to successfully integrate. So the advice we give is both analytical as well as social, down to the roots and traditions of people in their respective homelands, identifying strength and recommended types of cottage industries that can be incubated in a village setting. So one of the immediate goal of Namami is to bring employment to the rural areas and to help turn the traditional migration from rural to urban areas. Ashwita, as we know that, you know, the last few months have seen a full, you know, forced reversal causing the mass exodus of employment. Now,
yes.
The rural. So the work for Namami is now more crucial than ever before, with little to no employment in most villages. Traditional farming and no specialization, the need to attract innovation and investment in the rural setting is paramount. So whilst Namami extends from my passion to help those I was, you know, in my life, I also felt it was an opportune time to explore my entrepreneurial side, which led me to founding Majestic by Shweta Singh, a multi-consultancy for companies and individuals both here in India and the UK. We are working with biotechnology, healthcare businesses, fashion industries, you know, so everything is there. We do a lot of things which we provide. So, you know, if I just give an example, for example, we provided service and etiquettes training to healthcare providers in the UK. Coming from the service and hospitality industry myself, a healthcare provider retained my firm services to improve the service delivery at a multi-site provider. This involved carrying out an audit of the current service practices and then developing and implementing a bespoke plan to improve the client experience. My team and I work alongside the staff to gain first-hand feedback to see what was working and what needed to be changed. I believe that any service, whether it is for corporate or an individual, has to be customized to the requirements of the client. And a person-centered approach has given my business referrals across the group in India.
So a lot, many things that you are into, Shweta, and a lot of achievements, and then, you know, to say that too many feathers in a cap. So what should I say for you? Like, very commendable job, and you are an inspiration for so many of us, because we have the tendency to, you know, give a lot of excuses. Aisa nahi tha, waisa nahi hua, mere paas paise nahi the, mere paas wo facilities nahi thi, mujhe wo education nahi mili. या लेट से मुझे वो बैकअप नहीं मिला. बट इफ आई थिंक दैट कोई भी जो आपको सुनेगा, हु विल हियर दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन, विल गेट टू नो यू, विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट इफ यू हैव दिस ज़ील, अगर आपको कुछ करने की इच्छा है, यू हैव दैट ज़ील टू डू समथिंग, देन देयर इज नो नथिंग स्टॉपिंग यू, राइट? सो आई थिंक दीज आर ऑल एक्सक्यूजेस दैट वी एज ह्यूमन बींग्स, यू नो, वी गिव टू ईच अदर. व्हाट डू यू थिंक, श्वेता?
That's exactly what I said earlier, Shweta. You know, we should just stop making excuses. You know? Just find a resource around you, talk to people, friends and families. That's what I feel like. Being a woman, we need women who are empowering, you know, embracing and standing for each other. We need a sisterhood who doesn't, you know, point fingers on you, but who helps you to climb up. And that's what we are doing in GWC at the moment. Mm-hmm. And I'm proud to be a part of it, you know, because every day I learn so many things. And very important thing in life is the education, which is the basic necessity of every child's life. And it is the main tool, you know, which enabled me to reach such a position in life. So I want that, you know, every parent should, you know, have this zeal in them that, you know, they have to ensure that their children, they're educated. No matter, because my mother, she wasn't that educated. She just, you know, fifth standard pass. And still she had this, you know, thing in our mind that whatever happens, my children, they're going to study. And because of that courage what she had, and it was the, what, you know, she did, you know, went out of the box and did everything for us. It helped us what we are today. So, you know, unki mehrbani hai jo main aaj hu.
Bilkul, bilkul. We should never forget, you know, because it is because of them that we, it's our existence lies today. And as we say that hamare कुछ जो कर्मास है और हमारी जो कुछ जो टूवर्ड्स, वी हैव सर्टेन ड्यूटीज टूवर्ड्स आर सोसाइटी, वी हैव सर्टेन ड्यूटीज टूवर्ड्स आर पेरेंट्स, यू नो, टूवर्ड्स आर फैमिली, टूवर्ड्स एवरीवन एंड ईच वन ऑफ अस इन दिस यूनिवर्स. सो आई सी दैट, यू नो, यू आर जस्टिफाइंग एवरीथिंग दैट यू कुड डू, बिकॉज आप उस उन चीजों को आपने देखा है, यू हैव एक्सपीरियंस दोज मेनी थिंग्स एंड यू हैव नॉट फॉरगॉटन देम. And you are still very grounded, which I could, you know, really make out from your energies. You have such positive vibrations. And I feel, and GWC feel proud to be associated with you, you know. So indeed, it is an honor for us that you have come today and you are sharing your journey with us, your story with us.
It is an honor, Shweta, because, you know, this, you know, things like this needs to happen every time. You know, it needs to be on the message. Sometimes you're so demoralized in your life that you don't know what to do. And I think if, you know, we both of us, if, you know, doing this conversation, this talk show, if we can help at least one person, and, you know, and I think then, you know, our job is done. This is what is
done. Yes, I do completely agree, because aaj hum jo bhi kar rahe hain, chahe wo hamare forum Global Women Trainer ke forum se ho ya aap jo bhi kar rahe ho, hum sab ka yahi motive hai ki इस कॉन्वर्सेशन से, इस स्टोरी से, आपकी इस जर्नी से, यू नो, पीपल शुड गेट मोटिवेटेड. एंड एक और श्वेता सिंह बने, ठीक है, और बहुत सारे श्वेता सिंह आए, और यू नो, देन आवर कॉन्वर्सेशन वुड बी अ सक्सेसफुल वन. एंड इंडीड आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु वुड बी हियरिंग अस विल डेफिनेटली गेट मोटिवेटेड एंड डेफिनेटली विल गेट टू लर्न अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स फ्रॉम योर लाइफ.
And, you know, I would also say one thing, Shweta, like for my life, whenever I look into other people's, you know, like story, I look at it like, you never go into success stories, because I understand, like, everybody is like, you know, this person is so big, has achieved so much in their life. But look at the journey, you know, how it started. what, how many downfalls that person had. This is important because this gives you a lesson that if this person, you know, he has fallen so many times, but still he was able to achieve, you know, be there, then anyone can be, right? So this is, you know, this is what it is. You have to be very positive. Positive energy is needed everywhere. And you are like, you
know, yes, for sure.
Time if I'm saying about this. So be positive, you know. I just don't want to say something because people, they don't like listening, like be positive, do this. It's just that, you know, from other people, just take the experience, work hard, try hard. Make one way or the other, you will get the result. So look for the best option in life, you know. Just give everything of, you know, whatever you can, you know, try your best and just reach for the skies.
Definitely, definitely. That is what our motive is. That is the motive of GWC, that we want to convey a message to all the women entrepreneurs, to all the ladies, to everyone, in fact, that, you know, if you have that zeal, if you have that positive attitude in you, then nobody will stop you. No, there's no looking back. And hopefully a lot of people will get, you know, motivated today. Unko bahut acha lagega. And thank you, Shweta. It was indeed a pleasure that you took out time for GWC. And definitely we would like to connect again.
Definitely, yes. And I just want to add something, you know, just I want to spread across a message from my side to people. Always believe that nothing in life is worthwhile unless you take risks. As Nelson Mandela once said, there is no passion to be found playing small and settling for a life that is less than the one you're capable of living. So take chances. Don't be afraid to fail. Don't be afraid to think out of the box. Don't be afraid to dream big, because always remember every failed experiment is one step closer to success. So work harder, work better, leave a dent and reach for the skies, as there is no stopping us. And last but not the least, please take care, keep safe and keep smiling.
That's the entire idea. So you should have a happy face. You should have that positive vibes in you so that you can, you know, motivate others. So thank you, Shweta. Thank you so much for being there today. It was a wonderful and amazing experience that I had with you. So pleasure is all mine.
No, I'm really honored, Shweta. And thank you so much for having me on the show. And, I'm so happy to be interacting with someone like you as well today. And I think it's a learning stage. So today also, I've learned so many other things, you know, from we spoke before and from your experiences in life and everything. And GWC is doing an amazing job and I wish them all the best.
Thank you. Thank you. And same to you. God bless you. Take care. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.